Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept circles. Okay, so see, today's first theorem is if two chords of circle are equally inclined to the diameter through the section, prove that the chords are equal. Okay, so this is the given theorem. So see, here figure is given. If two chords of circle are equally inclined to the diameter through their point, see, two chords are given, AB and AC, are equally inclined to the diameter through their point of intersection. Point of intersection is here. Okay, so equally inclined means what is given? This angle and this angle is same. Okay, then prove that the chords are equal. Here we have to prove AB and AC are equal. Okay, so first in given two chords, chord AB and chord AC of circle COR. Okay, of circle COR. O is the center of the circle. Then equally inclined to the diameter. AOD, suppose we will take here point D, okay, AOD, equally inclined to the diameter AOD, okay, means what? Equally inclined means what? Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD, this is given, okay, BAD or BAO and CAO are equal. Okay, so that is given thing. Now what we have to prove? Prove that the chords are equal. Means here we have to prove AB and AC are equal. Chord AB is equal to chord AC. This we need to prove. Okay, so for that we need to do some construction. Okay, so we will take here from point O or from the center O, we will take perpendicular on the chords. Okay, so here we will take from this, so this is perpendicular, and here from this we will take here. Okay, so this is I am saying here N, and this is I am saying here M. Okay, so in construction we will mention draw perpendicular. Okay, draw OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to AC. Okay, this we need to do construction. So after construction you will get two triangles. So that is, there's two triangles, AMO and triangle ANO. Okay, so we need to think about the proof. Okay, so what is our target? Chord AB and chord AC are equal, that we need to show. Okay, so if we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so how we can prove both the triangles are congruent? So we need to think about that. So see here carefully about these two triangles. AO is the common side for both the triangles. Okay, then what is given, what we can see here, angle, both the angles, this angle M and angle N are 90 degree. And one more they have told us, that is BAD is equal to CAD, means we can say MAO is equal to NAO are equal, means two angles and one side, which is not included by the two angles. Okay, these two angles and one side is equal to the two angles and one side of the another triangle. So we can say by angle side, by AAS, both the triangles are congruent. So first we will prove triangles are congruent. So in proof we will write, in triangle MAO and triangle NAO, okay, so AO is equal to AO AO is equal to AO common side for both the triangles. Okay, then we can say MAO is equal to angle MAO is equal to angle NAO. Okay, why? It is given. And then next one is AMO, angle AMO is equal to angle ANO. Okay, each 90 degree. Okay, both angles are 90 degrees. So we have two angles and one side. Okay, with the help of this, we can say triangle MAO congruent triangle NAO by angle side. By AAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent, or SAA also we can say. So triangles are congruent means we can say, from this we can say OM is equal to ON. What is the reason? CPCT. ON and OM are equal by CPCT. If triangles are congruent, we can say OM and ON are equal. Okay. If OM and ON are equal, then we can say the chords, this is the distance. OM is the distance from the center to the chord, and ON is the distance from the center to the chord AC. Okay. So if OM and ON are equal, then both the chords are equidistant from the center. Both the chords, that is chord AB and chord AC, are equidistant from the center. So equidistant from the center means chords are equal. Okay, chords which are equidistant from the center, those chords are always equal. So here from this we can say, so chord AB is equal to chord AC. Okay, so these are equidistant from the center, so we can say chord AB and chord AC are equal. Okay, so this is the simple proof. See carefully and do this in your notebook. Our second problem is PQ and RQ are chords of circle equidistant from the center. Prove that the diameter passing through Q bisects angle PQR and angle PSR. Okay, once again see, figure is given. PQ and RQ are chords of circle. PQ and RQ are the chords of circle equidistant from the center. Both the chords are equidistant from the center. So one thing we will come to know that the chords which are equidistant from the center are always equal. Okay, so that is one of the properties. So here we got one thing, that is PQ and RQ are equal. Okay, so that one thing we have. Then prove that the diameter passing through Q bisects angle PQR and PSR. Okay, so this we need to prove. So here one thing you will understand, that if we are able to prove these two triangles are congruent, that is triangle QPS and triangle QRS, if triangles are congruent, these two triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can give this. This angle and this angle is equal, and this both angles are equal. So we can say QS is bisecting both the angles. Okay, but how to prove both the triangles are congruent? So first we will think given. What is given here? PQ and RQ are chords of circle PQ and RQ are equidistant from the center. Equidistant from the center. Okay, chords are equidistant from the center means what? Definitely QR is equal to QP. So this we can mention here, QR is equal to QP. This is one thing. Okay, then what is given? PQ and RQ are chords of circle equidistant from the center. Prove that the diameter passing through Q bisects angle PQR and PSR. Okay, so to prove that the diameter passing through Q bisects angle PQR, diameter passing through Q bisects angle PQR and PSR. Means what we need to prove here, see, PQS is equal to angle RQS. Means we need to show these two angles are equal and we need to show these two angles are equal. Okay, so QSR is equal to angle QSP. Okay, so these two things we need to prove. So here construction is not necessary. Only we need to think about these two triangles. But before that, one property we need to understand. That is, see, any circle is given, and this is the diameter of that circle. Suppose this is the diameter of that circle. Due to diameter, that circle is divided into two equal parts. Okay, and in that equal part, suppose I will take any angle on the circumference, that angle is always 90 degree. That angle is always 90 degree. Anyhow, we can take. Suppose I will take this is here and that I will take here, then this angle will be 90 degree. So that is the one of the property of circle that we are going to see in detail. But just you keep in mind, if such in such type of condition, that angle will be 90 degree. Okay, but it should be on the circumference or on the arc. Okay, so then only we can see if this the same angle will come like this. Both are intersecting, suppose here, then we cannot say this angle is 90 degree, maybe or may not be. Understood? So here we cannot consider, but if this angle is ending on the circumference, then we can say this angle is 90 degree. Okay, so that is one of the property of circle. Okay, and it should be in the semicircle. So see carefully, here this is the diameter they have told us. So definitely this angle is 90 degree and this angle is 90 degree. Okay, diameter QS or QOS is common for both the triangles. So two things we have, that is diameter, that is one of the side of triangle, okay, which is common for both the triangles. Then QR is equal to QP. Why? Because it is given that both the chords are equidistant from the center, so chords are equal. Okay, so and this is 90 degree angle. Okay, if we are thinking about RHS criteria, then is it possible to use here RHS criteria? What RHS criteria says, that is hypotenuse should be equal. Here hypotenuse is the common side for both the triangles, so that is fulfilled. And one side, any one side should be equal. So here QR and QP are equal and both the triangles should be 90 degree. So both are right angles. So here RHS criteria is applicable. So see carefully here, in proof, in triangle QRS and triangle QPS, QS is equal to QS, QS is equal to QS, common side for both the triangles, common side. Okay, then QRS is equal to angle QPS, each 90 degree. Okay, angles in the semicircle. Okay, that is the reason, and both are 90 degree. And third thing, what is that, is QR and is equal to QP. QR is equal to QP. Okay, why? Because equidistant from the center, it is given equidistant from the center. Okay, from the center, and chords which are equidistant from the center are always equal. So we have enough things to prove by RHS criteria. So here we can say triangle QRS congruent triangle QPS triangle QPS by RHS condition. Okay, so now here we have given both the triangles are congruent by RHS condition. Now what is our target? We have to show these two angles are equal. So now we can say, because these are the corresponding angles, so here we can say angle PQS is equal to angle RQP. Okay, why? By CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. The same ways we can say RSQ or QSR, angle QSR is equal to angle QSP. Okay, by CPCT both the angles are equal, these corresponding angles are equal. If these angles are equal, then we can say QS, so QS is the bisector. QS is the bisector of angle RSP and RQP. Angle RQP. Okay. So this is the proof of this theorem. Very simple. Only one thing we have learned, that is angle in the semicircle is always right angle. Okay. So see carefully and solve this in your notebook. Okay, see here, our third problem is equal chords AB and CD of a circle with center O cut at right angle at E. If M and N are midpoints of AB and CD respectively, prove that OMEN is a square. Okay, figure is given. See, equal chords AB and CD of a circle. Chord AB and chord CD are equal. Okay, so definitely the chords are equal means both the chords are equidistant from the center. That one thing we will come to know. Then cut at right angle at E. This is at right angle. Cut at right angle means this is 90 degree angle. Okay. Then if M and N are midpoints of AB and CD respectively. M is the midpoint of AB and N is the midpoint of CD. Okay. Then prove that OMEN is a OMEN. So for that we need to join this. OMEN means we need to join this here and it will be here. Okay. So when you will join this is the midpoint and this is the center. Okay. And we know that perpendicular drawn from the center of circle bisects the chord. Okay. Perpendicular drawn. So this is midpoint means it bisects. Okay. So this is also 90 degree and this is also 90 degree. Okay. So first in given, what is given? Equal chords. Chord AB is equal to chord CD. That is given of circle COR. Okay. With center O. Cut at right angle. Okay. Both the chords cut at right angle. Chords intersects at right angle. Okay. At E, right angle at E, that is given. M and N are the midpoints. M and N are midpoints of AB and CD respectively. Okay, prove that OMEN is a square. Okay, so for that to prove OM, quadrilateral OMEN is a square. Now is a square, we have to prove means what we must know the properties of square. Okay, and everybody knows the properties of square. What are the properties of square? All the angles are 90 degree and all the sides are equal. Okay. If we are able to prove these things, then we can say this given quadrilateral is a square. So now proof. Okay. So in proof, first what we will think? We will think about here what is given? AB and CD intersects intersect at right angle, E. Okay, so we can say AEC, angle AEC is equal to 90 degree, okay, this is given, Now, if we will prove here, we will join OE, okay, then it is divided into two triangles, that is triangle OME and triangle ONE, okay. So, in triangle OME and triangle ONE, okay. So, here OM is equal to ON, why, what is the reason OM is equal to ON? Because chords are equal, okay, chords are equal, so equal chords are equidistant from the center, so that reason we can give here equal chords equidistant from the center, okay. So OM is equal to ON. OE is the common side for both the triangles. OE is equal to OE, common side for both the triangles, okay. And OME is equal to ONE, right angles, both angles are right angle because perpendicular drawn from the center of circle, bisect the chord, okay. And we have taken center to the midpoint, so definitely that is 90 degrees. So here we can say angle OME is equal to angle ONE is equal to each 90 degree, okay. So these are these things, with the help of these three things we can say both the triangles are congruent. Here we can say triangle OME congruent triangle ONE, by RHS criteria, both the triangles are congruent, okay. If triangles are congruent, then we can say, what we can say here, OM is equal to ON, that is equidistant, so that is given. OM is equal to ON, that is given because chords are equal, so the distance from the center to the chord are always same, okay. And now we can say ME is equal to NE, this is by CPCT. If triangles are congruent, these are the corresponding, ME is equal to NE, okay. So now here we can say OM is equal to ON, so OM is equal to ON and ME is equal to NE, also angle OME, is equal to angle ONE is equal to angle MEN, is equal to 90 degrees. So all the three angles are 90 degrees, so definitely fourth one angle is also 90 degrees, okay. So these all things are giving proof that is quadrilateral is square. So with the help of these things we can say quadrilateral OMEN is a square, okay. So this quadrilateral is a square and that is our target, quadrilateral OM is a square. So see carefully and solve this also in your notebook. Thank you very much.